In this video, we're going to take a look at British General's Fortress range of consumer units. I've been joined by Rick, who's been stretching his legs alongside the canal, looking at the wildlife and soaking up the sun. However, looking at your face, it looks like you might have caught a little bit of that sun as well.
It was a nice day then. Am I right in thinking that the BG consumer unit here is the one that was previously reviewed?
Yeah, this one here, and I'll leave a link to it in the description, and all the great features that we pulled out of that video have moved across to the new 2022 version, and we know what happens with cars, don't we? They have the latest version, and there's a few extra bits that makes it even more special. So we're going to take a deep dive into the new 2022 Fortress consumer unit in this video. I'm sure the keen-eyed amongst you would have spotted this magnetic lid holder, and in the centre there you can see that magnet. So pop it into place, it sits on top of either a breaker, the RCCB, or the main switch, obviously preventing the lid from closing. Which means when we're, say, labelling up the stickers underneath the overcurrent protection devices at the end, that we haven't got to hold the lid with one hand, as obviously we insert those stickers, and this will be available from September.
I noticed as you were just sweeping across here where you're going to put the labelling, there is a bit of a recess at the front here, and there isn't on the previous version.
There isn't. So this step-down aperture has been added to the consumer unit to add more rigidity to the lid. So if I press the lid there, you can see next to no flex. However, on the original one, which I described as a substantial unit, in other words, a solid unit, you can just see a little bit of flex in that lid, and the new ones overcome that. The strengthening continues also by adding this rib to both the bottom and the top of the consumer unit. So when you're fixing it to the surface, it won't flex or move and keeps it in position.
We also look to have a design change on the lid of the consumer unit also.
Yeah, so if we rotate around, you can see this raised section here, and now above it is this new indented section. And the thinking behind that is obviously it makes it easier to locate the lid first time onto the base in the correct position by having the two, where previously we just had the one raised edge on the side of the consumer unit. Before we take the lid off, which needs only a slotted posi 2 for these screws and every screw within the consumer unit, you can just notice down here like a slim line blank, and if I show you what it looks like when it's not attached, that's in place in order to keep the IP rating up to IP2XC, something that Joe will cover in a Q&A question. If we look at the original board, you can just see the problem it overcomes. Down by the side of the main switch, obviously it doesn't matter which end we are, you can just see that very small gap there that this slimline blank overcomes by filling it in. Let's remove the cover, and again it's on both designs. I love the fact that we've got a captive screw here, because a screw on the floor is a screw I'll see no more.
Just looking at this here, it looks as though we've got pin crimps on the neutral conductors. And coming across over to this one, it looks as though they've been ultrasonically welded.
Yeah, good spot there. And again, remember when we're undoing terminations within consumer units, we must do them up using a Torx screwdriver. Done a whole series on Torx, but we shouldn't use a Torx screwdriver as a screwdriver. So I'm going to take my slotted posi 2. I'm just going to undo this. The thinking behind going over to ultrasonic welded is you get a bigger surface area of material connecting the neutral connection to the neutral bar. So that's why they've moved away from pin crimps. As Rick pops the neutral back in, I like the feature that carries across both boards being the fact that all the screws, the earth bar, neutral bar, breakers and main switch are backed off. The holes in the bars are generous for our conductors as well. There's a little bit of Loctite on there so they don't vibrate and fall out during transit. So I'm glad they've kept that feature going.
So then, guys, did this board come fully populated?
Yeah, the Fortress range has many configurations and variations, so we'll leave a link to it in the description so you can explore it yourself. And yes, I did choose a fully populated one. Had 9 breakers, the surge arrestor kit, and 2 RCCBs already in the consumer when it arrived. However, it might be that you want a different configuration and the Fortress range has got you covered, so I could have chose a consumer unit and the appropriate RCBOs for the loads in which I had.
Looks as though I've got you covered with an AFDD.
Oh, an arc fault detection device. And we now know under the 18th edition Amendment 2 of BS 7671 that certain circuits in certain locations will require an AFDD, and the Fortress range also has those products within it.
What type of RCD is it that we've got in here?
Again, 18th edition Amendment 2 says that we need to choose the appropriate type of RCD. Let's take a look at the ones that are within this board.
This RCCB has got Type A RCD protection.
Yeah, good spot, Rick. There's a symbol just there. And we know under the Amendment 2 of BS 7671 that we're moving away from AC RCDs, where we can't guarantee it's a purely resistive load. And it's nice to see that the Fortress range has already taken that out of the installer's hands and it's put A-type in, which really should be the minimum now for an RCD protection. And it offers additional protection because we can clearly see there that it's rated at 30 milliamps as well.
Next to the RCCB, we've got surge protection.
Yeah, and we know we can't really get away with not fitting it anymore in domestic dwellings. So there it is, located right next to the actual main switch in the perfect position, this Type 2 surge arrestor. So while we're talking about the surge, we can see it comes pre-wired within the consumer unit and is connected to a Type B 32 amp circuit breaker and not to the circuits of the RCCB. And the reason behind that is we have a configuration that allows us to have high integrity circuits.
Yeah, and I suppose if we wanted to, we could reconfigure the board to allow us to pop in this AFDD.
Yeah, we can, Rick. I agree with that. So if we look at this, we've got an arc fault detection device here. So if we had a circuit that required arc fault protection, we could rearrange it and install that in that section. Looking back at the original consumer that I reviewed on the channel, one of the things that I noticed was, A, we got a lot of positions that we could insert cable glands or exit points for cables. And this one here was designed to be for the tails. They've got this size hole on the side and top, which I think are in the correct position. But this one to me seemed a little bit too far to the left. So let's have a look. So when we look in here, you'd be bringing your tails in and you'd be coming up the back here. And obviously I've said before that there's a huge amount of room behind these consumer units dim rails. However, in that section there, bringing up your tails would be tricky in order to get them into the main switch. So British General have listened and they've moved it so it could actually come up from this section where there is a lot of room. So if we look at the new board and the positions of that hole, they've kept a hole here, if you wanted to do it, say for your tails, but they've also added a hole just here that can be taken out in order that your gland can be positioned. And as I drop it down, you can see now when we come through here, our tails can sit either under the dim rail or above it and swoop round with plenty of room in order that they can be installed within our double pole switch. And just to confirm, we have other options to come in with those tail glands. So if we look on the side, we have a position here as well as on the top. And I'd just like to say for the record, it was my feedback from my original video that suggested I would have liked that hole in this position here. So maybe we could call that the Gary hole.
Are you taking any sort of credit for that then?
I'm going to take all the
credit. Notice from your previous review, we had a lot of space around the back of the MCBs. I can see we've also got the same on this one and here, which will allow us, I suppose, to dress in the cables neatly.
Another thing that helps you make a better job of dressing in those cables is that bolt there, which is on both consumer units, is matched on this side here, meaning that when we back those off, that we've got a quick release dim rail section. So the entire section here can come off, making it considerably easier for the electrical contractor to install those cables nice and neatly. The subtle improvements in the Fortress range continue on even with the blanks. This is a blank from the previous board I reviewed, and we're all used to in the electrical industry clipping one of those into position like so. But now we're aware that we've got this little gap here as well. However, let's take this one back out and I'll show you the new blanks. There's considerably more material in them, so they're a lot thicker than they were previously, and they require you to put them in with a side rotation, so we have to rotate it into position. It also doesn't slide, so it doesn't move down. I'll put my smaller insert in to get rid of that small gap on the end. I'll slide my blank down into position, and now when we put it on top of the consumer unit in there, we can see we've lost that little edge there. We've got a considerably firmer blank. But in order to get this out, I couldn't push it through the board at any point. However hard I pressed, I wouldn't be able to get it through. How do I remove the blank? I need to use a key or tool to open the enclosure. In this case, a tool. So I back off the screws. I would need to lift off my lid. I would need to slide it away, rotate it to the side in order to remove it. So there you go. What a great improvement, a little subtle one, in order that our blanks are held firmly into position and require a key or tool in order to remove them.
So then, Gaz, the BG Fortress consumer unit is packed full of new features. I won't mind fitting one of them.
Well, luck would have it, the one we ordered and we reviewed today needs fitting at Lineside Studios and we need a volunteer in order to do it. However, as always, we want your feedback. Are you currently fitting split load consumer units? Are you currently fitting boards full of RCBOs? Or, as Rick would have you, fitting them full of AFDDs? We'd like that feedback below. Which was the outstanding feature that you thought that we showed today on the new Fortress range? Leave that comment below and we'll try and get back to as many as we can.
Let's get to it.